Nigel. Now, Nigel, you're Sarah's partner. Anything you want to say about what we just did with Sarah?
It's fantastic, absolutely. Overwhelmed with that.
Awesome.
Yeah, absolutely brilliant.
Lovely. And what do we need to do for you? What needs doing for you?
I think it's my back.
All right.
I see them back on my hip, all over. That'd be good.
Right, okay. Which
anxiety?
Hip?
Yeah. This side like now,
yeah. Yeah, that's cool. Yeah, it's all right. That'll all be taken care of. Right, so. Well, let me just ask the prayer again. So I'll just explain at this stage. Whenever I do healing, I always say a prayer. I address that prayer to the creator of everything, the all that is God. Some people try and get me to pin down a little bit more who it is that does the healing. And I consider, rightly or wrongly, that God is everywhere in everything. God is in nature, God is in everybody, all the children, all the animals, in the space around things, and that we can all access God, and that's the divinity that I ask for help. The energy gets stepped down by a team of beings that are recognized mostly in the Roman Catholic faith, even though I'm not practicing Roman Catholic, but I do recognize the existence of God and the existence of many of the Catholic, Roman Catholic saints. Right. Okay, so yeah, I do need to get you to stand. The surgeon working this time is called Dr. Oswaldo de Cruz. Dr. Oswaldo de Cruz, there's no dirt in it. There we go. If you can stand here.
Yeah.
That's it. The surgeon that's working through me, Dr. Oswaldo Cruz, as he's come into your energetic space, he's just given me one word, which is doubt. And the feeling behind that word is not you doubtful of the healing, but you doubting you, you doubting your ability to create for yourself a life here on planet Earth in accordance with your heartfelt desires. Okay, and he's telling you stop doubting. Stop doubting yourself. Have faith in yourself. Have faith in your goodness. Have faith in your integrity. When you say a thing, you do it. You follow through. Yeah. So don't let others diminish you, he's saying. Don't let others diminish you with their words, with their attitudes, with their energy. Start taking responsibility for your energetic space, which is, we feel it primarily on the inside, but it does extend beyond this physical form. And start choosing how you wish to feel. So I'm going to get you while I'm working, just to think of somebody, it might be a public figure, that you really think, I would love to have his confidence or his strength of character, his personality, somebody that you'd like to be like. And just imagine yourself flowing your energy as he does. Now, can you think of somebody like that?
Yeah, fictional.
Yeah, cool, a fictional one, yeah. That's cool. So imagine yourself as that person. Imagine yourself as that person. I have to say, the one that sprung to mind for me, if I was a man, it would be Billy Connolly.
Mm-hmm.
I just love that man's energy. He's got good energy. I don't like his bad language. Sorry, Billy, but I don't. Because you're funny without it, but you are funny with it as well. But there's something about his energy that is very, you know, he calls a spade, doesn't he?
Yeah.
He calls a spade, he's got a lovely sense of humour. And you can see him using humour to get himself out of any situation. Nobody would ever pick a fight with him, would they? He's witty, he's clever, he's an intelligent man.
Yeah.
To lift your head up straight, that's it. As I look at you, you're sort of, your spine's like this here,
yeah.
And it's curved here.
Right.
All right. And the reason that it's like that is you've tried to please everybody this lifetime.
Mm-hmm.
And guess what? You can't. You can't. Because they're never happy, are they? No. You can't spend your life trying to make others happy. What you've got to do is find what makes you happy. And that's not selfish. Because if you are happy, you're radiating happiness. So you've just got to find what makes you happy. But you've tried so hard to keep everybody else happy. That's all that you've done. That's what you're guilty of this lifetime, is trying too hard to please others. That makes sense, doesn't it?
It does.
So stop doing that. Just make a commitment that this is your life, and you're going to start doing now what makes you feel happy. Now, it also doesn't make you happy upsetting others, so you're not going to throw the baby out with the bathwater, but you're going to bring your life more into balance. That's what's going to happen. You're going to recognise, this is what I like, this is what makes me feel good, and do more of that. And it's small steps, it's little tiny steps. Oh yeah, it was just the other day I was eating something and I suddenly realised, oh my goodness, I don't like eggs. I've eaten eggs my whole life, and I suddenly had this epiphany that I actually don't like them. I'd learned to eat them as a child, but actually I don't like them. I'm 55. It took me to 55 to realise, why the hell am I still eating them? I don't like them. And there might be things in your life that you've either put up with or you've gone along with, but actually, no, don't like that. Now in this left hip there is a contraction of energy. Now, different tissues in our body process different feelings. The hips are major things. The right hip's a major step forward. The left hip is letting go of something in the past. So, I have to ask you, has your dad passed over?
No, not yet.
All right, okay. Is he quite an ill man at the moment, though?
No.
No?
He's old, but he's doing all right.
He's doing all right, yeah. Okay. Is there an issue between you and him that needs to be resolved, that hasn't been resolved yet?
I suppose there's plenty of issues, but I think we've moved past them without dealing with them, I think.
All right, okay. Mm. We've moved past them without dealing with them. All right, we've just swept them under the rug and hoped that they won't ever surface again.
Yeah.
All right.
Works out bad, I think.
All right, because I've got to stand this way and tell you that it's the hardest thing in your dad to say well done to you.
Oh, God, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah?
He can't do it. But the spirit doctor that's in me says you deserve somebody to say well done. You deserve somebody to say well done. Your father just can't do it. He can't do it. All right, so just accept that about your dad. That will help this hip.
Yeah.
All right, because he can't do that. Because you know why? Because he never says well done to himself.
Mm-hmm.
If you never say well done to yourself, nobody ever says well done to him either. That doesn't help.
No idea.
Yeah, so if you're not in the habit in your own head of saying well done, it's hardly going to come out your lips to somebody else.
Mm.
All right, now this energy that's locked up in the hip, it goes right the way back to childhood, because now you're a grown up. If he doesn't say well done, it's water off a duck's back. But when you were a kid, it would have been nice if just once, you know, kicking a football, swimming, at school, if at something he just said well done, wouldn't that be nice? It would have meant or everything to you.
Would have done, yeah.
It would have meant absolutely everything to you. But he didn't have it within him to do that. He didn't have it within him to do that. And that's his failing, not yours. That's what the surgeon wants you to know. That is his failing, not yours. Dad used to drink a bit too much at times?
No, I think that'll be me.
That's you, is it?
I think
oh.
So.
My dad liked he's in spirit world now, my dad bless him. But one of the things my dad used to say was he knew God wanted him to be happy because God invented beer.
Good answer.
Cheeky. Right, have a walk around, see how that's feeling.
Yeah. Yeah, it's feeling alright.
Feels alright,
yeah.
No pain?
Yeah, that's alright, is that?
Yeah, cool. Marks out of 10 for the surgeon.
Alright, thank you very much. Yeah, 10.
Awesome.
Right,
brilliant.
Yeah.
Cool.